organizer for Equality Across America and also join the Impact Chicago. Unite and Fight's LGBTQ conference started off as a call from Equality Across America, and simply just a call. We put it out to our network asking if people wanted to organize, do the dirty work, basically, for a bunch of regional conferences, and this is the first one. We are in Chicago at Columbia College, and we are about to have our opening plenary with Stacey Ann Chin, Richard Aviles, a youth organizer who spoke at the National Equality March, and the weekend is today is all workshops with all submitted by the community, and we're really excited. Main focus this weekend is full federal equality. While respecting the statewide movements, we need to secure our gains and our successes with the federal government, and we believe that we need to be working alongside local organizers and looping it all in and creating a network, and that's what we're here to do. So today, all the workshops, everyone powwows, and then tomorrow we all come together for a big, messy session. Do some regional organizing. It's the first time a lot of us have done this, so we're very excited, and we're about to go hear Stacey Ann Chin speak and officially kick things off. So,
excellent, Nick, and I want to always ask this question to everybody that organizes something: what inspires you? Like, why? What fuels your fire to do this?
Well, for me personally, I think a lot of people, and I'm 23, so a lot of people my age who were lazy like 2 years ago were really galvanized by Prop 8. Because especially my generation, Will and Grace is around, we've had Queer as Folk, we've had the L Word, we've had 6 Feet Under, which had a gay couple that won, you know, that won awards for how they portrayed our community. And then to hear California had it, then you think California has gay marriage, we're fine, we're going to be fine, and then to have it taken away. And like, for me, myself, I'll admit, I didn't know that Prop 8 existed until after it already happened. I didn't know. So that is what started the fire. And I was also in the right place at the right time in terms of starting, helping start Tony Impact Chicago. So seeing our work, even though for a long time we had no idea what we were doing, seeing people respond to that is what fuels me. But I was galvanized at Prop 8.
Excellent. Thank you for all that you're doing.
Thank you.
And such a huge success this weekend, I'm sure.
Thank you.
My name is Lawrence Perea. I am acting co-director with LGBT Change. We are co-presenting the Unite Fight Midwest Conference with Join the Impact Chicago, and we are sponsored by Equality Across America. Equality Across America is the grassroots network that brought the Wash March on Washington last fall. And so they wanted to reach out to the regions and establish a better organizing strategy for next steps to achieve full federal equality. So this is the Midwest Regional Meeting, and so far we've got about 300 official registrants, which is very exciting. That's our capacity here at Columbia College Chicago. And last night was a great kickoff event. We had a social hour. We had lots of performances from Youth Pride Center as well as Todd Kessler's band. That went off without a hitch. We had 75 new registrations last night. So today we're really excited to welcome Stacey Ann Chin. She's a spoken word poet and has been on 60 Minutes and Oprah and lots of different great social justice events. And so we're really, really happy to have her here. She'll be our keynote speaker for the opening plenary. And then we go into about 40 workshops.
Now, being an immigrant, talking about human rights in a country that's not really yours, it's a very interesting experience, and one that you didn't fucking choose, you know, like, I didn't sit there in Jamaica on the fucking coconut tree and say, like, yeah, I should move to America because, you know. But, I mean, but for being gay, I wouldn't be here.
But this is my community, for good or bad. And these are the people who are your sisters and your brothers, you know. If we could get a little more melanin in the room, I'd be happier. This is what it looks like so far, and so we have to kind of like hack away at this lump of unformed rock, and hopefully something gorgeous will emerge soon. Eh?
Oh, guys how do we use the workshop, and then also just as a participant to try to learn more about different people's perspectives, to try to get a better grasp on different areas that perhaps I'm not always in tune with myself. I think that so far this workshop is going great. As a staunch, non-emotional person, it's already managed to make me cry about 5 times in the short 2 hours that I've been here, and I'm really excited to see what's going to be happening in this next debate that I'm going into about marriage and whether or not we should be fighting for it. It should be pretty heated and pretty exciting.
Great. Thank you for all your work you're doing.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
I came out on the Rachel Maddow Show about a year ago. So me and Rachel are now going steady. It's been a year. But in lesbian terms, it goes a lot faster, right? U-Haul on the second appearance. I said 3 words. And that was illegal. That was a statement of homosexuality. That was a homosexual admission, which was essentially one of the 3 ways that you can get kicked out under Don't Ask, Don't Tell. It's also the most common way why most people get kicked out under Don't Ask, Don't Tell. And I want you to remember that.
So, full federal equality. I'm sure you will hear that more than once this weekend. So, we're here to kind of live out the vision of the National Equality March. A renewed and galvanized movement, many generations and many points of view representing many cities, towns, and states, coming together to find our way forward. By being here today, you are recommitting to achieving, actually achieving, not just talking about, but achieving the rights that are guaranteed to us as citizens of this country. The only path, in my mind, ends at the federal government.
At your vote, at your either. And I am evidence, and we are evidence right here, all of us who are sitting together. While we might have different opinions, and we might be from very different places, we are evidence that our standing up is possible, that our coming together for shared purposes is possible.